three functions. I know we have a large group of people who are hearing, vision, and vestibular slash balance researchers working together on this project. So really this links in with the clinics, and our goal is to be ready with our tasks, our different measures, as soon as the people are rolling through the clinic, Nairi, or Lynette, then we'll be able to do these various measures. So far I've been working with the Otago folk to talk about the vestibular imbalance measures, and Nick and Lee and Paul are confident that we've identified a time-limited vestibular measure that we can put into this clinical setting that will be sensitive to the kinds of changes that might be happening in older people with mild cognitive impairment. I myself have Oscar as my PhD student, who's actually will be the research assistant on this project in Auckland. And we've been piloting various behavioural and electrophysiological measures. And I have a master's student at the moment actually measuring language and auditory processing in people after stroke. And some of the measures that she's using there really are being piloted for our mild cognitive impairment study. So we have actually secured a location to do the testing in the medical school, and we have initially the visual processing tasks were identified by Ben Thompson, and now Stephen Dakin has come in, and we're very pleased that his very able postdoc Lisa Han has been looking at the literature and tweaking some visual processing tasks. So we have two tasks that are now operational that Oscar will start to be able to pilot with some older adults in the next few weeks. And we're working on ethics, which will be relatively straightforward because we're recruiting people who've been identified through the clinic. And so we can go through University of Auckland ethics, and Lee has confirmed with Otago ethics that once we have our U of A ethics approved, that can just go straight through their committee down there. One thing we have in Otago, which we don't have access to at the University of Auckland, is the equipoise balance system, but they have it at AUT, and I just had a chat to Nicola from AUT, so we have the possibility that we could also do those measurements in Auckland. So that's it from me.